What about, is it true that you work with some members of Earth, Wind & Fire then?
Or yeah, they produced an album for us in 1983.
Yeah, that must have been absolutely brilliant.
The Standing in the Light album. Mm-hmm. And it was very exciting going over there to work.
Are you big fans of theirs?
No. So it wasn't that exciting.
Oh, right.
it was kind of a... I mean, at the time, it was, you know, a big compliment that a group that sort of establishes them would be interested in producing. We thought...
So they asked you if they could produce your
album? Well, they said they were interested in producing us, and we thought, you know, it might be good to work with somebody new, and also to work in America, and maybe, you know, it might sort of give us a chance to perhaps get a foot in the door of the sort of American pop charts.
And did that work?
Not really, no. I mean, the album went very well.
There was a funny period, really, in the American charts, because they have what they called the British invasion.
What year are we
in
now?
83.
Right.
And so a lot of the top 10 action in America were like British artists.
Right.
And that when we went to America, we found that the guys from Earth, Wind & Fire were sort of sat there saying, well, come on then, fellas, you know, what is this sort of this European secret, this Euro sound? And we were sort of disappointed because we'd gone to America to try and find out what this American thing was. So we both sat there looking at each other, you know.
Especially working with American producers like that, and you sort of want to...
Well, I don't know really what we expected. They're very nice guys, I mean, you know, very nice. And they're very good musicians as well, but it was kind of strange. But we had this sort of standoff in the studio. They cocked an eye at us. We cocked an eye at them, and we stood there, cock-eyed.
When you do a sound check, I mean, you do some of your old songs, don't you, I should imagine, when you actually do the concert. So do you need to practice them in a sound check very much?
Well, we actually haven't played for, I don't know, 5 or 6 weeks now.
Yes.
And it's quite sort of terrifying, the thought of going on stage tonight, having not played for that long, and launching into a set that...
Stage
you,
fright.
You can never remember. Yeah, really, you still get it. I mean, if we've been together 12 years, it's not something that you ever really lose. And it's probably a good thing, because I think that the time that you get a bit blasé and, you know, would, say, put on wigs and just roll on stage with lipstick on, like our sax players, you have to take it a bit seriously, you know, so it's good to be nervous, I think.
This next piece features the Rhino Horns, and this is called Heaven in My Hands. Thank you.
nervousness. I would never have thought that Level 42 would get nervous. I don't know.
Yeah, it's sort of a, it's an apprehension rather than, you know, oh my God, oh my God, yeah. I can't do it.
Because you don't...
We know we can do it, but the thing is, we want to do it to the best of our ability, and we want to put on a good show for the people that are coming. And so, because we've not played for a while, you know, we were 3 months playing the same set Night After Night. We know it inside out, but sometimes when you know it so well, you sort of, you're not even thinking about playing it, you just play it. And so having had a break, you've got to suddenly think about it again.
Yeah,
it's just quite scary. Also, I think that the challenge is really the one that you set yourself, that you want to be good. And there's, I mean, there is a physical thing involved here of, if you've been playing regularly, you can do pretty much what you'd like to do. If you haven't, the mind's willing, but the body's weak, and you might not be able to make the things, you know. So
talking about the body being weak, I mean, you've been called the best bass player in the world and the person who invented slap bass and everything. What do you reckon when you hear people say that about you?
I've been called worse things than that.
Have you?
Yeah, I've been called a lot worse things than that. That's one of the nicer things, thank goodness. But it's not... it's very flattering, but it's not something that you can really sort of take that seriously. Unless you feel very depressed and then you
well,
say,
oh. Yes. Then you read the good reviews.
Yeah.
What about this thing with the slap bass? How do you manage to sing and play? I don't know if it's called slap bass, it's just something I call it.
It is. I mean, that's pretty much called sort of slap playing. And that adds, it's, I suppose, the style that I'm best known for. And it's something that, well, we just, it's something that I've always done in the band. And so it's not something that I consciously sort of think about how to do.